So you can talk as the engine is off, if you want to say, or the vulture. We have about four different kinds of vultures there. One is the biggest, is the lappet-faced vulture. Then the one dotted is the Griffon Rüppell vulture. Then there's one with a black head, black neck. That one is the white-backed vulture. Then the last, to the right, the second last going hooded vulture. Those are different, and all have work to perform there. When they find the kill, the one which has the big head, which we are calling lappet-faced vulture, does the work of tearing. Then they first take their share, then the hooded will follow. Not the hooded, the white back will follow, and griffon. And those two trying to fight each other are the griffon. And the one which is on the carcass, those are the white back vultures. So, but they all could stay in harmony, even on flight they are mixed up. All have very good eyesight. When they sight something lying down, as they are on a very high altitude, they keep lowering themselves until they see that there's no breath at all, there's no life. Then they will land on the side. They may use a tree where there's a nearby tree to the dead carcass, or they first land some distance and they keep observing. When they now observe and find there's nothing much, when they feel that there's no breath at all, then that's when they come. And the destruction is done by first removing the eye of the animal. Then later on, others may now take place, removing the intestine, removing all kind of fleshy part. But the first thing vulture does, as for the recent, you can see this other horn, the eyes had been plucked off. The one which has land and one flying, those are the lappet-faced vultures.
Lappet-faced?
Yeah, those are the one which do the tearing of the skin. Yeah, those two. Then griffons are these ones. Those red top are the lappet-faced, and they are the huge vultures. They are heavy, roughly maybe 4-5 kilos or above. They are really quite heavy.
They do the tearing?
Yes, they are the one do the tearing. And these birds in the wild help us sometime to locate where there's a dead kill, either by the animals, either poachers or natural death. So on the other side also, they help those who are in the monitoring and research department to try to find out the cause of the particular death of animal. So we take them also to play a role as we move around. We really think wherever you see a vulture, you have to stop and try your level best to find out
you must find
the
something.
Problem, whatever's occurred there. And doesn't only make us to know only the whatever kill, but also identify which particular animal could have done that. Is it man? Is it predator? Is it natural death? Is it through fight? And we normally compile this data and we give the information back so that it helps management to know way
the
forward.
Disaster, thank or disease or something,
yeah.
Epidemic?
Yes.
All right. I think you need to come down, get closer. That's not now the.
So it is really unusual to find two buffalo dead at the same spot. To me, I could take maybe eyes, maybe they try to fight.
Why does this one doesn't have this one?
No, because this is plucked off. It is just like the hoof, the shoes of the hoof. So this thing was there. So I tell you, there's what we call
interlock
presentation. When it locks and you cannot, you, because of the struggle, both of you may even land, but not in a proper position. Then when one die, you can also remove yours. You also go. And I was saying, it is much easier when they have already experienced that for any other predator or hyenas or something to feast on it. And from the scattered bone here, for me, it shows me the hyenas also took chances, because I'm seeing the bone so much scattered. That shows that, you know, hyena has got, they have strong jaws and they can break other bones. With the other cats, they may not break. They take the flesh and other sofa organs. But this is an indicator beside the vultures. As for instance, we can see the breaking of the bones. This shows that hyenas were here and did it. They can crush the bone. And this has lived in a very big, the big number of the hyena, we call it a pack. So I think the number was a pack that managed to clean this area. Yeah, this really happened in nature, and it is nature take its course. We cannot avoid it. That is it. Maybe only wish the two buffalo to rest in peace.
In pieces.
Not in pieces, in peace.
We've been having, when we saw the vultures in the distance, already sent a signal to us that there must be something down there. Indeed, after reaching here, this is the result. There have been two buffaloes dead. But now the kill, we don't know exactly what happened, but you can guess. As according to the explanation of our guide here, there may be a fight, because now find them two at the same position is unusual. Maybe if it was one, you could say it may be the fight between predators and one of them. But now when you find two of them at a particular point and all of them are just next to each other, it's fine. Maybe it tells us that the kill, maybe it was a war, the fight between two buffaloes, and perhaps cause this the reason of that death. And what, how did you know that? You know, by having a sign of the birds, those
the vultures.
Vultures, when they're gathering, anytime, it also has a signal to tip us that there's something, is like, well, come and witness, there's something happened here. Indeed, when we reach, we find this result. So it was not only the vultures and the buffalo, even the presence of hyena, it was being
observed
by the breaking of the bones. Because those vultures don't have capacity to break these bones. You find this is a result, if sure, there was also the presence of hyena. Of course, whenever there is a kill like this, hyena also have to take his share. And not only hyenas, the nature has to take their share. So as the story continues, go.
Good to go?
Yeah. I'm using the same password, so it's me. Please.
Those are called Abyssinian ground hornbill. To the left, ahead of your
The one with the red neck is the male, and the one with blue is the female. They paired up for life. Abyssinian ground hornbill. Yes. Yes. And the red is there, and they paired for life. Die also, there's possibility that the one which remains, the widow, may stay a couple, maybe 1 or 2 years without another one. But as time goes on, if they meet another one which has experienced the same, then they understand themselves and can make another mate. But in most cases, it's a bit difficult. When one dies, the other one doesn't take long. Also perish. Other people believe that they commit suicide, but I say maybe they have actual stress which stress their life and make their life less shorter. Right now, you'll find you are incomplete and you will not stay much longer. That's what I think transpired, that many people believe that there's a way they commit suicide. The vulture is trying to indicate sometimes also the lions come around inside. This is a campsite called Kakine. Campsite, and also it is an observation point. Sometimes also the lions may, because it has some rocks, lions sometimes also come and rest up here. I'm seeing some vultures hovering. Maybe there could be a leftover kill or there's something special. Maybe the engine off for a while. That is observation point. There's a telescope there. Observation point where
when the people are camping, you pinch your tent, you can go there and use the telescope, turn around, search it for whatever you want to see.
So we're here, huh? We are at the
Akini
campsite,
and also one of the most beautiful observation points.
Sure.
This is a place where we allow the exclusive camping, a big group for couples.
Overland like us, and overland enthusiastic. Sure. Let me try to share with my viewers, my followers, what are we seeing right now? Then when I say now, what time is it? Anytime you are watching, is that the time? So this is life. We are here on the top of the Peak Mountain, and this is how it looks like. Don't confuse, it's not yet a heaven, but it's a part of heaven on earth. When we name it, we nickname the Pearl of Africa. So that was a true Pearl of Africa. Look at the beauty. Wonderful scenery. And this is the place to be. And what a place. Yeah, look at the place. Wonderful, wonderful. It's absolutely magnificent. We're in the middle, the top of the hill, one of the hill for the observation. And, I think you can even enjoy with me as well. What I'm seeing is what you are seeing as well. So there's not like a Photoshop here. That's a really scene of what I'm seeing currently right now. And this is the place. Then before you become older, make sure you come and pay a visit. Something so attractive, and it really shows the beauty of the country. Show the beauty of the part of Africa. That's the reason why we are here. We're using our home for 2 weeks. That's the vehicle parked outside. Got a double cabin to the main city. And we are relaxed and we are taking our own time. That's the journey. Journey is about relax and drive at your own time. And the journey is about, again, whenever you see something interested, and you can share. And that's it. So beautiful, lovely, so beautiful, beauty. Something you really need to come and witness. Such journey, there's no rushing, and wherever you see something attractive, of course you stop and then enjoy the scenery. But here, see the scenery of the place. It's so quiet and peacefully, very, very peacefully. You can even be sitting, get your lunch as you really enjoy the game drive. And here, I'm even here seated like I do, and just enjoy the landscape, enjoy the beauty of the nature, of what the nature provides. So lovely, fresh air. Today. Fantastic. And right now I think we're gonna fly drone, because this I can't leave it. It's like every day I just want to take photos, because I can't leave it behind. It's like I want to take the whole of this place with me. How I'm feeling here. Hello. Listen, can you say something about this place?
No, we, if there's a way we'd take this home, would have been the solution to the love that we have for the nature. And now that we are not in position to carry the whole of the depot to our homes, our villages, our veranda, so we are going to catch pictures and beat photos and capture, arrest, some put in the pocket, and then we shall send
this. There's a special spread. And today really it was a fishing day.
Fishing spade.
Fishing today. Today was a fishing day. Oh, a lot of fish. Not animal. So
what are you by saying? Our eyes.
You know, there is everything has a, when you say this is a thought, food for thought. Feeding the brain. And the food for eyes. What, let me show this food. Hey, this one, yes, this one. This one. This is the food. And the rest, I would love to leave you there
and find your way.
Find your way.
Follow us, come.
If it's okay, then
you don't have a ticket to heaven.
Is what you say like this?
Yeah, that's what I'm telling
you. Oh, really, really love them, and then, yeah.
Subscribe,
make sure you keep in touch. You love them. All right, I think we must fly drone. It's very important here. We're gonna fly our drone and make sure we get the scenery. We'll share with you the aerial part of it on flying drone. The drone is among our filming gear. It was among the filming gear we got, so that, and plus the GoPro, as you can see, we have a GoPro here. So fantastic, we're gonna fly our drone and to get the aerial film, and we'll be able to share with you as well. So today it was really a lovely day, and what a day, so lovely. You can see here the scenery, and that's it. So wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. So lovely, lovely. Let's see. Wow. Kwenda pali Uganda nilifurahi na tingi tingi we. I am Noor Ismail Nozzle, diesel engineer. Join me as I share my passion for building four-wheel drive trucks and traveling to the remotest part of the world.